proprietary ratio. What does it mean? What does proprietor means? Proprietor means owner, isn't it?
Owner.
So here it means owner's fund, related to owner's fund. So proprietary ratio formula will be owner's fund or proprietor's fund, isn't it? Or proprietor's fund means shareholder fund, isn't it? Shareholder fund. And we check in proprietary ratio the relationship of owner's fund with the total assets. So shareholder fund upon total asset is the formula. By its name, it can easily be computed. Proprietor means owner, owner's fund means shareholder fund, and we check the relationship with total asset. It means that how much total asset is financed by shareholder fund, by owner's fund. So this is one of very important solvency ratio, comes under solvency ratio, which is normally used by the companies to check the long-term paying capacity of the business. Okay, so let's start with the numerical number 54. Fine, proprietary ratio. Question number 54. From the following information, calculate proprietary ratio. Share capital is given, non-current assets are given, reserve and surpluses are given, current assets are given. Okay, so we can calculate proprietary ratio. Proprietary ratio means shareholder fund upon total assets. And in the shareholder fund, what is given? Share capital will come in shareholder fund and reserves and surplus will come. So 3 lakh plus 1,80,000. So 3 lakh plus 1,80,000 divided by total assets. Let's check total assets are given or not. So non-current assets and current assets, when we add, we get total assets. So 13,20,000 and 6 lakh. 13,20,000 plus 6 lakh. So 3 plus 1, 4,80,000. Divide by 13 plus 6, 19, 19,20,000. It means it is 1/4, hai na? 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 0.25 is to 1. So proprietary ratio is 0.25 is to 1, or we can say 25%. Huh? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Very simple, shareholder fund upon total assets, hai na? So let's see one more question, question number 55. Question number 55. From the following information, calculate proprietary ratio. See, equity share capital is given, preference share capital is given, reserve and surplus are given, debenture and trade payables are given, hai na? So this is, and fixed assets, short term investment and other current assets are given. So total assets are also given, and shareholder fund, and in shareholder fund we need equity share, preference and reserve and surplus, isn't it? So proprietary ratio is equal to shareholder fund upon total assets. Total assets are given. We will calculate shareholder fund. Under shareholder fund, what is given? Under shareholder fund, equity share capital 3 lakh, preference 150, and reserve and surplus 75. These three points we will take. So 3 lakh plus 1,50,000 and 75,000. 1,50,000 and 75,000. So it will be 3 lakh, 4 lakh, 5,25,000. So shareholder fund is 5,25,000. Okay. So proprietary ratio will be 5,25,000 डिवाइड बाय टोटल एसेट्स एंड टोटल एसेट्स आर गिवन 7,50,000 है ना, 7,50,000 जस्ट डिवाइडेड 5,25,000 डिवाइड बाय 7,50,000 525 डिवाइड बाय 750 सो इट विल बी 70% और 0.7:1 और 70% इज द प्रोप्राइटरी रेशियो. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. एनी डाउट?
नो सर.
यस, इट्स वेरी सिंपल एंड प्लीज डू राइट, है ना, राइट इन योर कॉपी ऑल्सो. Let's start with the next question. Question number 56. Calculate proprietary ratio from the following. Equity share capital is given, 10% preference share capital is given, reserve and surpluses are given, creditors, debentures, fixed assets, trade investment, current assets are given. Okay, so we need shareholder fund and total assets. So first we calculate shareholder fund, hai na? Equity share capital will come 4,50,000. Equity share capital 4,50,000. 10% preference share capital 3,20,000. Preference share capital 3,20,000. Reserve and surplus will also come 65,000. Reserves and surplus 65,000. Okay, only these three points will come, and in total assets, fixed assets will come 7 lakh. Fixed assets 7 lakh. Trade investment 2,45,000. Trade investment 2,45,000. Current assets 3 lakh. Let us do the total. So it will be 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 lakh. Okay, and shareholder fund, let us do the total. 4,567,770. Let me do the total. Eight lakh thirty-five thousand is shareholder fund. We need to calculate proprietary ratio, and proprietary ratio means shareholder fund upon total assets. Shareholder fund is 8,35,000 and total assets are 12,45,000. Let us divide it. 8,35,000 divided by 12,45,000. So it is coming 0.67:1. Or if in percentage you want to write, then it will be 67% proprietary ratio. I hope it is clear to everyone. Written by all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's move on. One more question of proprietary ratio. Question number 57. Okay, state with reason whether the proprietary ratio will improve, decline, or will not change. Hai na? Because of the following transactions, if proprietary ratio is 0.8:1, okay, So proprietary ratio means shareholder fund upon total assets, and it is given 0.8/1. This is what proprietary ratio is given. Point number one, first point. Obtained a loan of rupees 5 lakh from State Bank of India. Okay. Obtained a loan of rupees 5 lakh from SBI, payable after 5 years. Payable after 5 years. So children, when we obtain a loan of 5 lakh, how it affect the shareholder fund? Is there any effect to shareholder fund? Increase, decrease or no change? Please tell me. Tell me, children. When we take loan of 5 lakh from any bank, will it affect the shareholder fund? Anushka? Huh? Tell me. Simran? No idea? Janvi? At least say yes or no. If you do not know, say no, sir.
Huh? Sir, it will affect.
How it affect? Shareholder fund.
Decrease.
Are, there will be no change, na? No change. No change in shareholder fund. Shareholder fund means share capital. Hai na? There will be no change in shareholder fund. But when we take loan, total asset will increase because cash will increase. Yes or no? So total asset will increase. So when total asset will increase and there is no change in shareholder fund, ultimately, or hence we can write, proprietary ratio will decline. Yes or no? Is that clear or not? Hana, there is no change in shareholder fund. 0.8 remains same, but 1 will increase. So ultimately the ratio will decline. Hana? It's very, very simple. Point number 2. Let us see what is given. Purchase machinery of rupees 2 lakh by check. Okay. Purchased machinery of rupees 2 lakh by check. Okay. So let us see how it affect proprietary ratio. Will it affect the shareholder fund? Tell me.
No, sir, it will not affect.
When we purchase machinery, shareholder fund means share capital, preference, reserve and surplus will be not affected, dear children. It will be not changed. Okay. Now tell me, will total asset affected?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Somebody are saying no, somebody are saying yes. You decide finally.
So
net
effect will be zero. Yes, sir. That effect will be zero. Because the asset is increasing and decreasing.
Asset is increasing. How it is decreasing?
Sir, the machinery is purchased by money. So the machinery will come and the money will go. So it will increase and decrease by that way.
But we have not paid na cash. By check, it means we have paid through bank, है ना? Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, okay. So it will be not change. When there is no change in shareholder fund and total asset, how will it affect the proprietary ratio?
Sir, there will be no change.
हाँ, proprietary ratio will not change. Very good. Very good. I hope this point is clear to everyone. Let's see the next point, what is given. Third point, redeemed means, dear children, payment, hai na? We have paid, hai na? So redeemed 7% redeemable preference shares of rupees 3 lakh. Third point, redeemed 7% redeemable preference shares. Redeemable preference shares of rupees 3 lakh. Let's see what happened. Proprietary ratio means shareholder fund upon total assets. Now tell me, by redeeming preference share, will it affect the shareholder fund?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes,
sir.
Yes,
it will decrease.
Yes, it will decrease, definitely. Shareholder fund will decrease. Will it affect the total asset?
Yes, sir, because the cash will decrease.
Yes, it will also decrease. Now, but here there is one problem. Both are decreasing, but ratio is 0.8 and here is 1. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, comparatively, shareholder fund and same amount, both are decreasing with same amount. Decrease with same amount. Both are decreasing with same amount. But one problem. Listen carefully, dear children. Both are decreasing with same amount, but the ratio is not same. Ratio is 0.8 upon 1. When both are decreasing with same amount and ratio is not same, comparatively, shareholder fund is affected more. Do you understand? Shareholder fund is affected more than total assets. Hence, proprietary ratio will decline. Do you understand? Tell me. Say yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because the ratio is different. Shareholder fund is 0.8 and total asset is 1. But the amount is same, that's why the ratio will decline. This is what the reason. Hai na? Good question. Next point. Fourth point. Issued equity share to the vendor of building purchased for 7 lakh. Okay. Issued equity share. To the vendor of building purchased for 7 lakh. Building purchased for 7 lakh. So now equity shares are given when building is purchased, cash is not given. Is that clear? We have purchased building from a vendor, and for the payment of 7 lakh, we have issued equity shares. This is what the question. How it affect your proprietary ratio? Let's see. Proprietary ratio means shareholder fund upon total assets. Hai na? And we have seen that proprietary ratio is 0.8 upon 1. So let's see, will it affect equity share cap, equity share, when we issue equity share, will it affect shareholder fund? If yes, then how it will affect? Tell
it
me.
It will decrease.
Arre, shareholder fund will increase na?
Sir, increase.
Haan. Yes sir, it will increase.
We have issued equity shares na? We have issued equity shares, so shareholder fund will increase. Increase with same amount. Yes or no?
Yes,
and,
sir.
And total assets? Yes, sir. Is there any change in total asset? Yes. We
yes,
have
sir,
purchased.
Yes, I purchased.
We have purchased building, and building is non-current asset. So building will also increase with the same amount. When both are increasing with same amount, but ratio is not same, ratio is 0.8:1, it will affect the shareholder fund more than total asset. So hence, ratio will improve. Hence, proprietary ratio will improve. Because comparatively, it affects shareholder fund more than total assets. In terms of percentage. Okay? Hana, is that clear to everyone? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. I think there is one more point. Fifth poll, 10% redeemed, 10% redeemable debentures of rupees. Just a minute. Of rupees 6 lakh. Okay, let's see what happened. How it affect proprietary ratio? Proprietary ratio means 0.8:1 is given in the question. Shareholder fund upon total assets. Tell me, dear children, when we redeem debentures, will it affect shareholder fund?
Yes, sir.
No.
No, sir.
It is debenture. Debenture is loan. Loan is not the part of shareholder fund. So it will not affect shareholder fund. So there will be no change in shareholder fund. Okay. Will it affect the total asset?
Yes, sir. It will decrease because
yes,
the cash is going.
Yes, out. It will decrease because we have redeemed. Redeemed means paid. How we have paid? Maybe through bank or through cash, hai na? So your total asset will decrease. When total asset decrease and there is no change in shareholder fund, ultimately what will happen? Hence ratio will improve. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Hence proprietary ratio will improve. So I hope all these questions are clear to everyone.
Yes.
Question number 58. Calculate proprietary ratio if total assets to debt ratio is 2:1. So total assets to debt ratio is given 2:1, means total assets upon debt. On this value is given 2:1, or we can write 2:1. If debt is 1, total asset is equal to 2, and debt is given 5 lakh. So debt is given 5 lakh. If debt is given 5 lakh, it means total assets is twice the debt. So 5 lakh into 2 lakh, 10 lakh. So we have computed total assets 10 lakh in this manner. And debt is given 5 lakh, equity share capital is 0.5 times of debt. So equity share capital according to question is 0.5 times of debt. So 5 lakh multiply by 0.5 is equal to 2,50,000, isn't it? So this is your equity share capital. And preference share capital is 25% of equity share capital. Preference share capital is 25% of equity share capital. So 250,000 into 25% means 1/4. Let us calculate 1/4. 250,000 divided by 4. So it is coming 62,500. Okay, and then net profit before tax is given and tax rate is given 40%. So net profit before tax is given 10 lakh and rate of tax is given 40%. So when we subtract 40% tax, 40% is 4 lakh. What we get? We get 6 lakh. And this is what? Net profit after tax. Net profit after tax. What we need to calculate? We need to calculate proprietary ratio in this question. So to calculate proprietary ratio, the formula is shareholder fund upon total assets. So total assets we have computed 10 lakh. Just we need to calculate shareholder fund. Shareholder fund we can compute in this manner: equity share capital 250,000 we have computed, preference share capital 62,500 we have computed, and net profit after tax is required. That also we have computed. Net profit after tax 6 lakh. So let us do the total. So 62,500 plus 6,788,50,000, 9,12,500. 9,12,500 is shareholder fund. So let us put this value in the formula of proprietary ratio. 9,12,500, and total assets we have computed 10 lakh rupees in this question. So 10 lakh rupees is total assets. So now proprietary ratio will be 0.912:1, or you can say 91.2% in percentage if we want to write. So I hope this question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children.